Hello viewers, welcome to Lingu TV, a station where you watch and learn. I'm your tutor, Phyllis Tivit. Today I'm going to take you through English from 4, lesson 1. Our topic will be on grammar and the subtopic will be on nouns. So we'll first look at the lesson's objective. By the end of the lesson, the learner will be able to describe the uses of noun in given sentences. As we look at, can you look at functions of noun? In a sentence, a noun can function as either the subject, the object, or a complement. As you can see from the diagram, those are the common types of noun. And if you can define, you can say a noun is a naming word of a place, person, or a thing. If you look at the graph, we have the different types of noun, that is the common noun, proper noun, collective noun, abstract noun, and concrete noun. When we talk of proper noun, these are nouns that name specific things. For instance, cities, people, and places. If we talk of common noun, these are the general names that they refer to people, places, and they do not, with the proper noun, they begin with the capital letter, whereas in common noun, they're just the general names. If we look at abstract nouns, these are nouns that cannot be touched, but we can feel them. Collective nouns, these are nouns that are grouped together. You can see from the examples of proper nouns, we have Kenya, England, Nairobi, and then if you look at the examples of common concrete nouns, we have them as names of things that can be seen or touched. This is the directly opposite of an abstract, whereas abstract names of things that cannot be touched, such as honesty, love, corruption, music, atmosphere. Abstract nouns are collective nouns are a group of collection of persons, things, or animals. For example, a herd of cattle, a fleet of sheep, a pack of cards, a crowd of people. Can we look at noun as a subject? And you can say a noun usually forms as a subject of a sentence when it performs the action implied in the verb. When it performs the action implied in the verb, the noun functions as a subject. When it is the topic of that verb, the noun functions as a subject. When it is the topic that predicate talks about, the noun acts as the subject of the sentence. We can also look at proper nouns are used without determiners or modifiers. Proper nouns are used without determiners or modifiers. And remember, we said proper nouns are those nouns that name specific things, people, or places. Example, Mount Kilimanjaro is the tallest mountain in Africa. And they've said they're used without determiners or modifiers. July is usually a cold month in Makueni. Now, can we look at noun phrases as a subject? We can still use common nouns are normally accompanied by determiners, quantifiers, or modifiers. Example, the boy suffered from malaria. The boy will be our subject in the sentence. A noun as a subject, two or more nouns can be combined to form a compound subject. Can we look at the example over there? Marcy, Caroline, and Jennifer are students from Sinket Girls. So, Marcy, Caroline, and Jennifer are our compound subject. We go to noun as a subject, you can say, when a singular noun forms a subject, it must always be followed by a singular verb, and when a plural noun is a subject, it must always be followed by a plural verb. Example, Sinket High School is the best high school. So, in the first statement where we have Sinket High School, it acts as a singular subject. Whereas the is in between the sentence is a singular verb, the best school in the county. So our subject will be Sinket High School. And it's followed by a singular verb. Good. Example in sentences, the elephant destroyed our crops. The trader bought various goods. A noun as an object. A noun functions as an object when it receives the action implied by the verb. Objects occur in sentences that contain transitive verbs. Types of objects, we have the direct and the indirect object. Can you look at direct object and you can say, these nouns usually come after the verb or verb phrase, whereby the direct object can be a single noun of a noun phrase. A point to note, in order to identify direct objects in a sentence, you should ask the question what or whom after the verb. Example, she is the subject, verb is making, object is a lot of money, and you just said you can, in identifying direct object, you should ask the question what or whom. So she is making a lot of money. What is she making? A lot of money will be our direct object. Mercy adores her baby sister. What is Mercy adoring? Her baby sister will be our direct object. Can you look at the indirect object and you can say the noun or noun phrases functioning as an indirect object always comes before the direct object and cannot stand on its own. An indirect object can either be single noun or a single noun phrase. Example, Sharon bought her baby a beautiful dress. Sharon bought her baby a beautiful dress, and you just said an indirect object comes before the direct object and cannot stand on its own. So our direct object is the baby, or our indirect object is what was being done to the subject. It's a beautiful dress. Michael gave John important hints about work in the mines. The old man gave Musa clear directions to the cave. A noun as a complement. A noun function as a complement would follow the linking verb. A complement refers back to the subject of the sentence. Example, she remains the chairperson of the group. They became doctors. He is a pilot. So the words involved are the complementary words. Assignment. Having said that on a noun, the direct and the indirect object in nouns and the noun functioning as a subject, object, and the topic. And the subject, object, and the topic of the sentence, at the subject of the sentence, sorry, we can try the following assignment. Identify the noun and noun phrases that are used as subject, object, or complements in the following sentences. We'll try the assignment over there. Format on these on nouns as a subject, a direct and indirect object, you can refer them to Excelling in English, Students Book 4, second edition, published by the Kenya Literature Bureau. You can also contact us on SMS line posted on the screen, YouTube Elimu TV, Facebook Elimu TV, Twitter @Elimu_TV_KE. Thank you for the lesson.